Hello people, I'm Andrew Whyte from New Zealand and welcome to my vlog again this week. We're working on the Waikato painting and once again it is an oil colour mixing tutorial. Last week we worked on the earthy green tones in the mid-ground layers and this week we're going to work on some of the more dramatic highlights that are going into this golden light painting of the Waikato area of New Zealand. Right, let's get to work. Okay, what we're going to be doing today for the Waikato painting is mixing up the highlights for the midground and the foreground. So it's rolling hill country farmland in warm golden light. So I'm thinking we're going to need some warm golden paint to help us in this endeavour. So I'm going to be using some raw sienna, some yellow ochre, and I've also got my pallet some Gamblin gold ochre paint as well. Let's see what we can do with these colours. We're also going to need a bit of green. Some of the darker trees in the painting will need a darker colour and also a light highlight green as well. Some leftover paint from the other day, sort of a grey green colour. Let's just put this on the pallet as a good start. So I'll just put that aside over there. Might find a use for that one later. It's a good idea to keep the palette knives nice and clean when you're dealing with other paint. Gotta be real careful you don't cut yourself on the palette knife. That's one of my common things to do. Clean up the palette and let's get some of this paint going. This is raw sienna. Straight out of the tube, it's a Round the Artist product. Quite an earthy yellow. Put it right next to it with some yellow ochre. I'll clean my palette knife again so that the pigment's nice and pure for you so you can see. And the other type of pigment that I'm using is gold ochre, which is a Gamblin product. Very similar to yellow ochre. Probably has a little bit more red in it, I would say. You could quite easily mix that colour up yourself if you wanted to. But, like I say, pre-mixed paints are great. You don't have to do too much of the hard yards. So I'm actually going to mix the yellow ochre and the raw sienna together. Something I commonly do. And as you can see, that colour has become very, very similar to the gold ochre colour, which is right next to it, which is straight out of the tube. Almost identical. Look at that. Okay, mix all three together. A rich, ochre-y colour. Because I'm actually putting this paint on top of the other paint that's already on the canvas, I'm going to use some archival fat mix. These already come in the bottles, ready to go, and honestly, it's by far the easiest option for you. The other option is to mix turpentine and linseed oil together and create your own. I think there's just something else in that stuff that I'm not sure what the chemical composition of it is. I'm not a chemist by any imagination. There's something else in it that just seems to work so much better. Put some more yellow ochre with it. Now I'm going to introduce another pigment, which I'm fond of using. And that is raw sienna. Try and get the lid off it. Here we go. I've used that one for a while, that tube. Anyway, this is raw sienna. Let's just show you what that looks like. Here we go. It's a dark, earthy colour. If I mix it with a little bit of what we've got on the palette, to brighten it up just a little bit. Well, quite a lot, really. slightly darker yellow as a result. I'm just going to put that over there. Let's see what else we've got in the pallet and the box. That's where my full tube of raw sienna went. I do try to keep my colours separated as much as I can, but as you could imagine, everything just gets all mixed up. Sometimes I write on my tubes if they get too obscure. This is a typical artist's collection of paints, which I'm sure you can relate to. Now this one here is a pigment called light red. It's an earthy red tone, like a rusty coloured red. Now this one is very, very good for landscape painting as well. You can mix it with a little bit of raw sienna so it's not so rusty. Or maybe even brighten it up a bit by mixing it with some of that gold ochre and raw yellow ochre. I'm going to have a little bit of that on the palette too, because that will keep the palette moving. Some of this grey that I had before, I want to warm it up a little bit, so I'm just going to mix it with some of the light red. Now that colour will be quite handy into the shadows. That's good. I'll put that over there. Find my lid, put the lid back on. Right, put a little bit more fat mix around into everything as well. Right, let's see what I can do with some of the highlights with what I've got. I'm going to use a nice big brush. So I'm just having a bit of a mix-up of all sorts of colours. Now I just want to put a little bit of Terra Versa into it. This is cadmium green. This is a very, very bright green. Now this will change the colour of just about anything quite significantly. And as you can see, it's created a real deep grassy green. I want to put a little bit more with it actually. Put a little bit of fat mix with that. Let's make some more highlights. For that, I'm going to use yellow ochre. Mix it with a little bit of that lime green that we had going there. chair is quite squeaky today, isn't it? Hope you're learning to ignore that squeaky chair of mine. That is pretty much yellow ochre straight out of the tube there, and I'm going to be using that on the highlights in the hills. Okay, now there's a lot of pine trees and forested areas through here, so I need to start building some of these trees around here. Some of them are quite sporadic. And also this area through here, which is still blank canvas, which is going to be rolling hill country as well. Now the light is not getting into here, so this is going to be quite dark, although there might be some light just coming in across the tops of the hills through into here. For example, as it's done here, it's picked up on these highlights in the grass country. It's all about the sun and where the sun falls, particularly at this time of the day, because it's so contrasting, the golden hour of light that we get, either at sunrise or at sunset. Looking good, huh? I'm happy. Happy, happy, happy. Let's move on with some more colour mixing. Now, once again, I'm looking for a deep green. Clean a bit of the space off on my pallet so that I can do this. Chromium oxide green. Let's have a look at this colour. It's a Gamelin product, artist oil colour. Straight out of the tube. Very much a blue green. That would have its uses in a lot of landscape painting, definitely. You can actually make that colour yourself simply by adding a little bit of ultramarine blue into a green colour. Anyway, let's put that one aside. Let's have a look at sepia straight out of the tube. This is a Rowney Artist product. Sepia has a lovely smell to it. I love the smell of sepia. Don't ask me what gives it that smell. Mixing it with a little bit of that chromium green to see what I can get. And as I thought, I'm getting a dark green colour simply by bringing those two together. Chromium nature of that green means it's quite dominant, it's quite bright, and it will change the colour of anything around it. So my sepia has gone to a deep, dark green, which is great. Probably need a little bit more of it. So let's mix those two together again. Fantastic. I'm going to need a lot more of it. So let's put a bit more on the plate. Let's mix the two together. And we've got our deep dark green in a useful quantity. Now you'll be thinking, I'm going to have to use this as lean mix as well as fat mix. Lean mix on the bare part of the canvas and fat mix on the part of the canvas that's been painted, because I'm going to use this for two things. I'm going to use it for the trees on my in and around my highlights, and I'm going to use it for the base colour of my foreground layer to the left. You can't see it at the moment, but when I bring the camera up, I'll refresh your memory. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take half of it, put it over here. I'm going to mix some fat mix on the left. Lean mix on the right. Lean to the right. I'd be leaning to the right. So my paint on my right is lean, and the paint on my left is fat, which means it contains more oil. And I'm going to just put a little bit of liquin, impasto liquin, into my fat mix as well. It'll help it dry off a little bit faster, and also it'll help it adhere to what's underneath it. This is my fat mix green. And as you can see, it's gone almost black. What I'm going to do is mix up just a little bit of titanium white with it. Only need a fraction of it. Right, that's what I'm looking for. Okay, we're going to leave the Waikato painting where it is today. It's looking good. The Kaimai Ranges through there. The rolling South Waikato, or the North Island of New Zealand, through there. I've got a bit more work to do on the painting though. So join me in the next one, next week, and we'll conclude this painting with one last colour mixing tutorial. I'm Andrew Whyte. Have a wonderful week.